the whole system that we live in drills into us that we're powerless, that we're weak, that our society is evil, that it's crime-ridden, etc. and so forth. It's all a big fat lie. We are powerful, beautiful, extraordinary. There is no reason why we cannot understand who we truly are, where we are going. There is no reason why the average individual cannot be fully empowered. We are incredibly powerful beings.
Now, I think I spent 30 years of my life, in the first 30, trying to become something. I wanted to become good at things. I wanted to become good at tennis. I wanted to become good at school and grades and everything I kind of viewed in that perspective. I'm not okay the way I am, but if I got good at things, you realize that I had the game wrong. The game was to find out what I already was. Find out what I already was.
We've been trained for individual differences to stand out. So you look at each person, the immediate hit is brighter, dumber, older, younger, richer, poorer, and we make all these dimensional distinctions, put them in categories and treat them that way. And we get so that we only see others as separate from ourselves in the ways in which they're separate. And one of the dramatic characteristics of experience is being with another person and suddenly seeing the ways in which they are like you, not different from you, and experiencing the fact that which is essence in you and which is essence in me is indeed one. The understanding that there is no other. It is all one. And I wasn't born Richard Alpert. I was just born as a human being. And then I learned this whole business of who I am and whether I'm good or bad or achieving or not, all that's learned along the way.
The old appeals to racial, sexual, and religious chauvinism, to rabid nationalist fervor, are beginning not to work. A new consciousness is developing which sees the earth as a single organism and recognizes that an organism at war with itself is doomed.
Finish his shows with this. Life's like a ride in an amusement park. And when you go on it, you think it's real,
because that's how powerful our minds are. And the ride goes up and down and round. It has thrills and chills, and it's very brightly colored.
And it's very loud, but it's fun for a while. Some have been on the ride for a long time, and they begin to question, is this real,
or is this just a ride? And other people have remembered, and they come back to us, and they say, hey, don't worry.
Don't be afraid ever, because this is just a ride. And we kill those people. Shut him up. I've got a lot invested in this ride. Shut him up.
Look at my furrows of worry. Look at my big bank account,
my family. This has to be real. It's just a ride. But we'll kill those good guys
and try and tell us that. You ever notice that? And let the demons run amok?
But it doesn't matter, because it's just a ride, and we can change it anytime we want.
It's only a choice. No effort, no work, no job, no savings of money.
Just a choice right now between fear and love.